Hello, in this video, I'm going to be sharing 5 tips for you to maintain your motivation throughout your PhD journey. Welcome back to my channel. My name is Ayodeji Matuluko and I'm a PhD student in Glasgow, Scotland. I'm going to be sharing tips that have helped me throughout my PhD journey to manage my motivation. So number one, you need to learn how to prioritize. Make the PhD your number one priority in terms of looking at your career, in terms of your academics. Prioritization is very important because you could be at different stages of your journey. So for example, you're writing a paper or you're writing parts of your thesis, or you're preparing for a conference presentation, or you're preparing to collect data, you're analyzing. So at each point of the PhD journey, you have different things that take your focus. It's important to make the PhD your priority. You need to allocate a certain amount of time or a certain amount of hours each day or each week to your PhD. So make your PhD priority. So once you make it a priority and you decide how much time you're going to give it every day, it makes it easier for you to focus on your journey and hit your milestones at the right time. You always have it in mind that your PhD is your number one priority, so you're going to always give it the number one focus alongside all your other important interests. And so, for example, if other opportunities come up alongside doing your PhD, it doesn't mean that you're going to totally ignore them. It just means that because you know your PhD is a priority and you know how much time you need to give your PhD in a month, in a week, in a day, you are not trying to now fit your PhD into all those other interests that come up. Instead, what you are doing is fitting those interests into the time that you have left outside your priority, which is your PhD. So that way, you're able to have a good balance and focus on the important thing, which will help you achieve your final goal of actually having a doctorate. So that links to my number two tip on how to manage your motivation. You need to learn to say no. Yes, say no. So once you've established that your PhD is your priority in this journey towards becoming a doctor of philosophy, you are able to understand what other things you can take on. So for me, for example, I have my career goals, my life goals, my professional goals, everything written down. And I know that in the midst of all of this, at this stage I am in my life, finishing my PhD is a priority for me in number of years that I have to finish it. So when other opportunities come up, for example, I need to present at a conference, which is an important part of the PhD, or I'm collaborating even outside my research with other people to write papers or to serve on committees in a professional organization, I'm always conscious of the fact that my PhD is my priority and I have this additional amount of time, which is a limited amount of time that I can contribute to the other things. And so what I do is I do an analysis of where I am now. So number one, always keeping in mind that the PhD is my priority. I look at how much time I have. I look at my life goals, my career goals. And if the opportunity fits into the current career goals, the life goals that I've set for myself, and also thinking about the time I have available. So if I go through that process, it makes it easy for me to determine what I will say yes to or what I will say no to. And some things might look so juicy, like opportunities that you cannot miss and you're so scared to say no. But you need to be realistic. You need to be very realistic because you know that you have a limited amount of time to finish this PhD. And you need to get it done. You don't want to stay here for donkey years, still working on the same thing. Because the earlier you finish, it's easier for you to then move on to other things and move on to the other interests and focus on other things which are also your priority. So doing that process helps you to determine what you say yes and no to. And that's the process that I've been able to, I won't say perfect, but I've been able to work on that process throughout my PhD journey because I've been involved in so many things. So for example, I've served in professional organizations, I've volunteered, I've done a number of conference presentations, I've written a publication, I've co-authored publications. So how I was able to fit all of that into my current schedule was by always keeping in mind that the PhD is my priority and then seeing how I can fit all of that. When I'm able to take on all those things that are interesting and that fit into my career goals, it also makes it easy for me to see what else doesn't fit. And then I can easily say no without feeling guilty. And don't feel bad about saying no or thinking, oh, this opportunity will never come up. Opportunities come and they go. And that opportunity will still come up. And sometimes you might not need to outrightly say no. Maybe you can say, okay, not now, but maybe in so number of months or so number of years. But just letting people bring these opportunities to you know that, yes, I'm interested, but this are my current priorities, this is how my schedule looks like, and it's a very good opportunity. Thanks for having me in mind. But I would have to say no at this point, or I would have to put it on hold at this point. That also helps you to gain respect, because people will know that you're somebody who has good time management skills and that you're very focused and clear on what your goals are, and that way you're somebody that people would find it easy to work with. And that also helps you not to feel too overwhelmed, because when you take on so much, there's a tendency for you to become overwhelmed, and then you realize that you're not even giving enough time to your PhD. And there's also the risk of getting distracted. So yeah, the PhD can be tough, and then you feel like, oh, let me do some other things which can take my mind off the PhD at this point. There is a tendency to veer off into another direction and get so distracted by this other opportunity, such that you start to spend more time on those opportunities instead of your PhD. And then, even though there's an advantage to that, because sometimes it means that you can come back to your PhD with a fresh set of eyes, the thing is, you run the risk of not hitting milestones on your PhD and kind of lagging behind. So it's about striking a balance and being clear on your goals and always having them at the back of your mind in any decision that you're taking along your PhD journey. So my third tip is for you to develop a schedule, develop a daily, weekly, or monthly schedule. And I've written about this in a post that I made on my blog. The link is in the description. Developing a daily or weekly schedule helps you to keep on track. To-do lists are your friend. For me, personally, I use to-do lists a lot. So what I do is, I have my calendar, which I have printed out, and I also have on my laptop. So I sit down and I determine what I need to achieve in my PhD. So for a lot of us, that when we start our PhDs, and even as we go along in the PhD, our supervisor encourage us to develop Gantt charts. And I was very familiar with Gantt charts coming from my master's degree. What a Gantt chart does for you is helps you to identify key milestones along your project, which is your PhD, and then determine the timeline for them. That is when you need to achieve certain things by. And so doing that helps you to kind of see what progress you need to make. Things will not always go as planned, because sometimes you underestimate how much time things will take, but it helps you to keep on track. For me, I regularly review my Gantt chart and adjust the timelines as I go along. And so I always have a picture at the back of my mind of where I need to be at each point of my journey, what I need to be achieving in the next 3 months, 6 months, and always looking at my end date, that is the expected end date for my PhD, looking back from that date and then kind of mapping out the different milestones leading up to that date. I know what I need to be achieving the next 3 months, 6 months. I plan strategically tasks that I need to achieve at each of those stages, and then I also take it back and I try to map it out on a weekly timetable and see what I need to achieve each week. And then working with my to-do list for each week, I write out what I need to achieve for each week, what I need to be achieving that month. So I kind of have that small picture, big picture outlook, and it helps to keep on track. So, and that good thing about having to do this is that you can see what you need to achieve. And for me, I always asterisk things that are very important. So I kind of categorize things according to the level of importance each week and each month. And then I'm also able to cross out items on the to-do list as I achieve them. And then also what I do is I work together with my Outlook calendar or my Google calendar, and I put each item that I need to achieve each week, each month into my calendar, so reminders pop up for me throughout the day, throughout the week, and I know what I need to be achieving. It is not a totally foolproof method, because things, like I said, will not always go as planned, but it helps you to keep on track. So even when you feel tired and you don't want to do anything, when you look at your plan for the week, for the month, for the quarter, and you look at your weekly to-do list, it helps you to see what you should be doing. When you don't feel motivated, you're able to see, okay, this is what I need to do, and you're able to then continue along the journey. And that links me to my fourth point: you need to show up. I've written more about this in the piece on my blog, which is in the description box below. Showing up means that, like I said, there are going to be really down times where you're just tired, and sometimes you've taken on so much work that you need, especially if you're doing things outside your PhD, or you're just tired because the PhD journey is stressful. So there are times when you really just feel low, but you need to push yourself to actually show up. So what for me I do, especially since the COVID pandemic and we've been working from home for over a year, what I usually do is I get up, I go take a shower, and I sit down at my desk, and then I open up my notebook, which I use, and I check through my to-do list for that week. And then I check through my calendar and I see what I need to be doing for that day, and I kind of just get a picture of what needs to be done for that week. That kind of keeps me on track because I feel like, okay, I know where I need to start from. Then I find that when I actually start working, because I have that plan and because I feel like, okay, I'm doing something, I'm on track, my motivation level starts to rise and then I just want to continue working. And on those days where I show up, even when I'm tired, I find that I even achieve much more than I ever imagined. So it's important to also be resilient and just persevere and know that there are going to be hard days and you just need to show up. You need to take breaks. Take breaks. Don't work for too long. Don't burn yourself out. You need to be taking breaks along the way. You need to prioritize rest. So for me, what I even do in my calendar, in my to-do list, there are times when I even put a note to myself that you need to go and rest. And that serves as a reminder for me that, okay, I need to rest. I need to go and eat. I need to sleep. One of my priorities is also to sleep well, because I find that my sleep can tend to be really poor, especially when I'm stressed out and anxious about my work and there's a lot of workload and maybe there are deadlines I need to achieve that are just coming together. So when I prioritize sleep during those periods, I find that I wake up feeling refreshed. I have more clarity in what I need to achieve, and that helps me to continue with my plan, which I've already laid out. And it's a really good system because I already have my plans. I have what I need to do in my calendar. I have my to-do list. So when I come back from those breaks, I'm back on track. So it's easy to maintain motivation and just keep pushing through along the way. And don't forget to celebrate your small wins. So you get a chapter of your thesis finished and you've been able to send a draft to your supervisors. Yeah, celebrate that. Even though you know you're going to get feedback and you might need to do more work on the chapter, but at least you've achieved that. Or you submit a paper for publication, or you give a conference presentation. Those are small milestones along the way that you need to celebrate, because that helps you to keep motivated. Just make sure that you're always acknowledging that you've put in the effort and you've done this, and just celebrate. Make yourself happy, order some takeaway, take yourself out, go for a walk. Just make yourself happy and celebrate each small win along the way, and you find that when you come back, you feel more energized, you feel much more happy. So yeah, those are a few of the tips that I have for how you can manage your motivation during a PhD. And of course, there's so many other tips which I have not shared. Let me know in the comments if you have specific strategies that you use to manage your motivation throughout your PhD journey, or if there are any aspects of motivation during a PhD that you want me to touch on, and I'll be happy to do a video on that. If you want to read more about the strategies that I've used to manage my motivation and productivity throughout my PhD, you can also follow the link to my blog, which is in the description box below, and let us engage together in the comment section and let me know how you found this video. And if you want me to do any other videos on any other aspects of the PhD journey. And as always, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel and turn on post notifications so that you'll be notified when I post the next video. I'll see you in the next video. Thank you very much for watching. Bye.